I want to humbly beg this honorable house set aside all relevant rules for me to enable me move this motion that borders on the affair of our dear nation. Of course, a lot of us have heard what is going on about MTN and our government. My honorable speaker, I want to beg that I'm given an opportunity to move this motion at this very particular time, sir. Thank you.
In terms of the motion itself, I deem it very, very urgent. I so support that to consider it as such.
Those in favor of the motion say aye. Those against it say nay. Ayes have it. Any second limb of the motion, Honorable Zepania. Those in favor of the motion say aye. Those against it say nay. Ayes have it. Honorable EJ, you can now move your motion.
My name is Honorable EJ Agbonayinwa, representing the good people of Ego Ibubaha Federal Constituency, one of the most marginalized constituencies in those states. My honorable colleagues and dear speaker, I want to read before you this motion that says that the need to investigate the payment made by MTN on the fine levy by the Nigeria Communication Commission.
Order, please.
NCC.
Honorable members, please, silence.
Let the House note, the Federal Republic of Nigeria Official Gazette number 101, Government Notice number 229, Nigeria Communications Commission, Registration of Telephone Subscriber, Registration 2011, B1125-1134. Let this House further note that Nigerian Communication Commission in October 2015 fined MTN for violation of Section 19 and 20 of the Registration of Telephone Subscriber Regulation 2011. That is Part 4, which carry penalty, and it reads, Section 19, any licensee who fail to capture, register, deregister, or transmit detail of any individual or corporate subscriber to the central database as specified in this regulation or as may be stipulated from time to time by the Commission is liable to a penalty of $200,000 for each subscription medium. Subsection 2 reads, a licensee who activates any subscription medium without capturing, registering, and transmitting the personal information to the central database commits an offense and shall, on conviction, be liable to a fine of 200,000 naira for each unregistered activated subscription medium. And Section 20, subsection 1 says, any licensee who activate or fail to deactivate a subscription medium in violation of any provision of this registration is liable to a penalty of 200,000 naira for each unregistered but activated subscription medium. Subsection 2 reads, where the Commission is satisfied that a body corporate is culpable, the director, chief executive officer, manager or secretary shall also be liable to a fine of 200,000 unless, having regard to the nature of his function in that capacity and to all the surrounding circumstances, he proves beyond reasonable doubt. One, the offense was committed without his knowledge, consent, or connivance, and two, that he took all reasonable precaution and exercise due diligence to prevent the commission of this breach. Let this House be aware that MTN specifically violated Section 19, Subsection 1 and 2, and Section 20, Subsection 1 and 2
order
of the Nigeria Communication Commission NCC Act cited above. Let me further aware that MTN ought to have been fined under both Section 19 and 20, respectively, with cumulative penalty of 3.1 trillion 200,000 and not the fine of 1.04 trillion, which is a gross violation of the combined reading of both Section 19 and 20 of the Nigeria Communication Commission NCC Act. Let this House observe.
Order, please.
That MTN.
Order, honorable members, please.
50
silence, please.
Billion into the recovery account in violation of Eastern Act. Let this House be dismayed that the Nigeria Communication Commission, the regulatory body, was not part of the negotiation process with the MTN. This action is not in the best interest of our dear nation, Nigeria. Let this House resolve to all the House to refer the matter to the Committee of Telecommunications for further investigation pursuant to Section 88 of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria as amended, which gives this House the power to investigate, the power to investigate, to do our oversight function. Two, that the Committee on Telecommunications investigate the extent to which the non-compliance of MTN to the provision of the law allegedly led to the death of over 10,000 Nigerians, and whether MTN can escape criminal liability under the law merely paying fine, no matter how punitive the fine may appear. My Honorable Right Speaker, Jacobu Dogora, my dear colleagues, I so move. Thank you, sir.
Second,
please go back to your seat. Please, Oshun Caucus.
I hereby second the motion as moved.
My Right Honorable Speaker and my dear colleagues, of course, my dear colleagues, the motion read by your humble colleague. Now, let me say this. Does MTN, going through all this, have more power than the Federal Republic of Nigeria? Does MTN have more power than this Honorable House? Because why I'm saying this.
Order, please. Honorable EJ, lower your volume, please. Lower your volume.
My Chief Whip, I want to tell you, it's just an advice. But this, I will tell you that those at home, that they've lost their family, their loved ones, they probably will be crying right now, Mr. Chief Whip. Because this is very pathetic. That the negligence of MTN have led to the death of many Nigerians. I heard Mr. President on his press briefing that it's not about the fine. It's about those officers combating the menace of Boko Haram insurgency. Those that be kidnapped. This insurgency that has taken place for too long. For the law enforcement not being able to identify, to track those with telephone, you know, who have MTN line, because they were not captured in the database. And NCC, who is the regulatory officer, who fined them, gave them a sound warning in violation what they have committed. And MTN agreed of the guilt when this House to the House Committee of Telecommunication wrote MTN. MTN wrote back that the House should go and ask the Chief of Staff, Attorney General, and the Federal Minister of Justice that they will not discuss anything with the committee. Now, Mr. Honorable Speaker, my dear colleagues, if they run to the court just to defy justice, immediately they got the letter, they went to court. Now they are back negotiating without NCC, who is the regulator. They have refused to come to our committee. They say they are bigger than the law of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, that is MTN. Can they do this in their own country, South Africa? Is Nigeria a topic ground, for God's sake? There's a law. We must obey the law. We must abide by the law. As much as we want investors to come to this country and do business, and they must do the business, and they must follow the rule of law. My honorable colleagues, you all know what is happening. What MTN owe, the fine, the total fine, is 3.1 trillion in calculation of the act. That Section 19 and Section 20 carry a total order, of 3.1 trillion 200,000. So, order, my dear colleagues, let's save Nigeria. Many souls have been lost. It's not about the money, but the law must be followed to logical conclusion. Nobody is above the law in this country. I am not above, Mr. President, not above the law, and MTN cannot dictate for Nigeria. I thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak on this very, very pathetic, disappointing, appalling issue. Thank you. God bless you, Mr.